foot structure and weight bearing. Before we move on, answer this question. I've been asking this question for the past 20 years, and interestingly, youngsters, usually under 18, get it right 90% of the time. But people over 18, 90% of them get it wrong. But after watching this video, you will get it right. Hi, this is Ina-jan, pedotist and Anklebone alignment specialist. Since 2003, while I was working as a Disney animator, I started to analyze foot structure and its mechanics from animator's viewpoint, how the foot is designed to carry a body that is constantly moving with entire body weight. And today, let me show you how the foot, especially at the bottom of the foot, is designed to handle tremendous weight, especially the arch area here. But most people not using our foot properly for weight-bearing function. Did you know the average foot weighs less than 1.5 pounds? And the adult American weigh 170 pounds. And all that weight ends up at the bottom of the foot, roughly the size of the palm. When walking, the other foot goes into the air. In that stage, the foot on the ground carries the entire body weight. And the ground reaction force adds more impact at the bottom of the foot. So when walking, the impact at the bottom of the foot becomes 1.5 times of the body weight. And when running, the impact becomes 4 times of the body weight because the ground reaction force becomes much bigger when we run. So having plenty of cushioning at the bottom of the foot is absolutely critical. The cushioning provided by the soft tissues like muscles, ligaments, fascia, fat pads, and these soft tissues absorb impact and distribute weight and protect the body from getting damaged. First, I want you to notice the arch can be divided by 2 parts, high medial arch and low lateral arch. High medial arch constructed with the ankle bone and all the bones in front of the ankle bone, and low lateral arch constructed with heel bone with all the bones in front of the heel bone. So the high medial arch, blue color part, structured with 8 bones. Low lateral arch, green color part, structured with 4 bones. So high medial arch has much stronger structure. And notice the center line of the tibia, the main leg bone, where the weight falls is in line with the highest part of the arch, where the second metatarsal bone is, where the second toe attaches. That line also makes the center line of the foot. And the leg bone stands on the ankle bone, so weight falls on the high medial arch. And we should put our body weight on the high medial arch like this, not like this. It's because high medial arch area have more room to fill in with the cushioning, the muscles and ligaments. So as you can see, first, I want you to notice right under the ankle bone where the weight falls, the leg bone stance is concave. See how empty it is? This part right under the leg bone is filled with thick foot muscles. In these photos, you can compare the size of the empty space under the high medial arch on the big toe side with the low lateral arch on the pinky toe side. And notice how much higher the space is directly under the high medial arch, providing much larger space for the soft tissue to fill in for cushioning, about 5 times thicker than under the low lateral arch. So just keep that in mind, and I will show you with the foot image. From this image of the medial side of the foot, we can see how the arch part is designed. First, look at the bone structure of the arch. The arch is formed by
a group of small joints on top of the foot, collectively known as the tarsal joint. Now, for the soft tissues, here ligaments are colored in yellow, muscles in red, and fatty tissues in blue. See, on top of the foot is just a thin layer of ligaments and a thin layer of muscle, not much of cushioning. That is why dropping something on the top of the foot hurts. But at the bottom of the foot, or the plantar view of the foot, over 95% of soft tissues in the foot are located here, especially under the arch. First, beneath the tarsal joint is densely packed with multiple layers of ligaments called plantar ligaments, short and medium length, connecting the joint right under the tarsal joints. And beneath these thick layers of ligaments lay the foot muscle called plantar muscle. Over 95% of foot muscles filled in the arch area. The thickest?
Under the high medial arch.
Right under the ankle bone, where the leg bone stands. And beneath the plantar fascia muscle is well-known plantar fascia ligament, which attach at the front of the heel bone and attach to the back of the metatarsal head. This long plantar ligament wrapped in multiple layers of fascia, the connective tissues, rich in cushioning properties. That is why this ligament got its name as plantar fascia ligament. So the arch part is filled in with most foot ligaments and muscles. And under the heel bone and the ball of the foot are some fatty tissues providing cushions for the heel and the ball of the foot areas. Now from this image with some labels, we can see the arch part has the major cushioning system right here, with thick plantar ligaments, muscles, and plantar fascia ligaments with thick fascia to bear about 75% of the weight that falls to the bottom of the foot, and the heel and the ball of the foot areas with only the fatty tissues are the minor cushion system to bear about 25% of the weight that falls to the bottom of the foot.
So you know the correct answer for this question.
Now back to this image. The word plantar came from the word plant. So the plantar side of the foot, the bottom of the foot should be planted to the ground like root. I think that was happening in the Garden of Eden when Adam and Eve walking barefoot on the ever soft soil. So the arch was filled with soft soil and bears the weight.
So the bottom of the foot was planted into the ground.
So the tarsal joint always in alignment. So no foot or major joint problems back then. But on flat surface, the arch is unable to bear any weight. As a result, all the body weight falls to the heel and the ball of the foot areas.
And they end up carrying more than 3 times the weight they are designed to handle. So on the flat surface, our foot is literally getting tortured by not being able to use the arch part that designed to handle 75% of the body weight. These photos taken from under the foot while standing on a clear plastic show that the high medial arch not bearing any weight. As a result, the heel and the ball of the foot area, which relatively very small areas, are compressed under the entire body weight. This pressure squeezes out the blood, causing them to look white, which indicates the blockage of circulation. This localized blockage disrupts overall circulation, since blood vessels are interconnected throughout the body. These Harris-Matt footprints show how the fat pads in the heel and ball of the foot flatten from carrying a lot more weight than they are designed to handle.
On top of that, each step we make, while the other foot swings through the air, the leg bone bends forward, transferring the full body weight through this tarsal joint. In this stage, the tarsal joint definitely falls, throwing the entire foot bones out of alignment, including the ankle bone on which the leg bone stands. On tilted ankle bones, the entire body structure goes out of alignment, causing biomechanical problems throughout the body.
And biomechanical problems is a lot more complicated than just mechanical problem of man-made machine. This chart of the fallen tarsal joint syndrome explains all the problems of the tilted ankle bones. It's like foundation goes off, the entire structure goes out of alignment, causing so many problems throughout the structure. Though it's not rocket science, you can watch another YouTube video explaining this fallen tarsal joint syndrome in detail.
So to prevent all these problems, we need to use orthotics on the arch. So we can utilize the arch part for its weight-bearing function and keep the tarsal joint from falling. However, the orthotics
must align both tilted ankle bones at the same height.
We can find out with ankle bone alignment test whether the orthotics are aligning ankle bones at the same height or not.
Using the orthotics that make you fail the ankle bone alignment test can worsen your foot and major joint problems.
Today, I talked about how the foot is designed to handle tremendous weight with all the soft tissues right under the arch. And in order to utilize the soft tissues as a cushion, we need to use orthotics. So we can utilize entire foot bottom, including the arch, for weight bearing and to keep the tarsal joint from falling. And you can watch different videos about how to do the ankle bone alignment test and how to stand and walk correctly. Bye for now.
I published a couple books with many drawings for easy understanding, so you can check them out on Amazon. Until aligning our tilted ankle bones at the same height, the foot and major joint problems would not be healed properly. It was about foot structure and weight bearing.